Natural.
Yep, nice. I think your dad will be happy to see the house so clean and so nicely decorated.
What time is dad coming home tonight?
He said he should be home by 7.
1.5 hours more to go. I can't wait. I really hope he comes back on time.
Don't worry, if there's anything on, dad will have called us already. He never comes home late without telling us.
Yes, yes, I know. He always tells us. Everything must do properly once. Uphold the law, maintain order, and keep the peace.
Your dad is a very responsible and committed man. He loves his job very much. And I remember last year, he spotted a loan shark runner at UT MRT, and he chased the poor fella until Choa Chu Kang MRT.
I remember that story. Dad told me that guy ran until his shorts became loose and fell off. And the guy kept on running without his shorts.
Yeah, yeah, and the guy couldn't even outrun our dad. He had to lie on the floor, half dead.
Yep, that's your dad. He doesn't give up. Already, where is he? Called his phone but no one picks up. He said he'll be home by 7 but it's 9:30 now.
Yeah, he'll always call if he has last minute things to do. Jen, wake up. Call him again.
What? You call out, you're the one holding the phone eh.
Yep, I'm playing a game. You're very free now, right?
Stop it already, I'm very worried now.
Finally, I'm so hungry. Let's go here.
Yay, can eat already!
Where have you been? You know everyone is worried. The kids are worried. I'm worried. Don't even call.
Sorry, dear. I really tried to reach home by 7. I actually left the office by 6 o'clock. But something happened when I left.
There's an armed man with a knife in the playground over there.
Where? Show me!
Let's go!
Money. No one wants to help us. My relatives and friends don't even care. No one cares!
Uncle, my mother told me about auntie's condition. It must be very difficult for you. Please calm down.
She needs so many chemo sessions. The medication is so expensive and my job pays so low. And I can barely keep up with my child's expenses. Just let me die. My wife's going to die anyway. So what's the point?
Sir!
Don't come any closer, or I will kill myself!
Sir, take it easy! Calm down!
Go away! It's not what you think! I just want to die!
Sir, it's my neighbor! Uncle, don't be like that! Please put down the knife!
Don't come any closer! Back off!
Sir, it's okay. We can help you. Just talk to us.
His wife has cancer and he can't afford the bills.
What do you expect me to do anyway? I'm just a cleaner. No one even wants to help us. My relatives don't even care about the situation. So what's the point of living anyway? Just go away!
It's okay, sir. We can help you. Just put the knife down!
Lies! That's what you then you leave my wife to die. So what's the point of living? Just put me out of my misery.
Sir, put the knife down or I will.
Please stop, I can help you.
I can help too.
Yeah, I can help too. My mother had cancer and my father passed away a few years ago. I was broke like you, but my teachers helped start a crowdfunding campaign. If they can help me, we can help you too. People do care.
Please, let us help you.
So I told the man, don't lose hope. Let us help you.
Wow, Dad, you really are a superhero.
Dad, you're so cool!
No, I was not the superhero. It was the passers-by. All I could do was shout at him. He was already losing hope. I told him not to give up, but I was giving up myself. Only when the people spoke did he have hope again. I'm really very thankful to the people.
Wow, this is really heartwarming. Everyone was coming in to help to keep our country safe.
Together, we are stronger and can overcome any crisis or obstacles. This reminds me of what I learned in school this week. How we need to remember the need for total defense and where everyone plays a part in responding to threats and challenges.
Oh yeah, you're right. Together we keep Singapore strong.
Yes, that also reminds me of the story of Nian. Every year, Nian used to come out and haunt the villagers, and when the villagers unite together, they fought the beast off. The villagers would...
Yeah, Mom, you told us many times. We even watched the video made by Unique Productions a few years ago.
Okay, this time I'll forgive you, but the next time this happens again, I'll be the one appearing with the knife.
Okay.
Okay, come on, let's go eat. The food is getting cold.
We are having steamboat. Of course, things are cold, right? It was the passers-by who were the superhero. I told the man that.
Go away!
Uncle, are you okay?
I've had so many chemo sessions. The job... oh, never.
No, I got talking.
What do you all say? You just throw me into jail and you put your son in the orphanage.
Cut, got people. Sorry.
Wishing everyone a happy Chinese.